Welcome to my channel. My name is Lore. This vlog is me embracing the fact that I have this urge to binge read manga like crazy. I just want to read it all. Everything I own, I want to read it. Everything I don't own, I want to read it. I'm just such in a manga mood, and that is largely due to Jujutsu Kaisen, which I finished all the volumes that are out now in English. Yeah, I just like want to devour all the manga I can get my hands on. I want to watch a lot of anime. I want to watch a lot of K-dramas. I've even picked Girl From Nowhere back up again, which is great. I started it about two-ish years ago, maybe 1 year ago. Two-ish years ago. Which, speaking of Girl From Nowhere, in a very old video I made on this channel, I believe it was a manga readathon. Not a great video. I don't recommend anyone watch it. But in that video, I said this. And the reason for that is it's 742 pages long. I went into this expecting more Jennifer's Body, and I feel like the vibe was more like Nano. And I swear to God, the other day, I literally found a video where someone said that Nano was based off of Tomie, or is it Tomie? I've heard it pronounced both ways. I swear to God, I'm a genius. I am a genius, because how did me 2 years ago say, oh, this has more vibes like Nano, and then come to find out 2 years later that character really was based off of Tomie. Like, it's insane. I'm a genius. A genius. Anyway, I'm currently reading Spy Family Volume 9 and Queen's Quality Volume 1. I want to read these, and then I literally will read any manga. Like, at this point, I'm thinking of starting everything and just watching everything. So let's enjoy this journey together. y'all. So here is the first update for this vlog. I have been able to read a ton and, you know, I figured it's time to check in. Okay, so first up, I finished Honey Lemon Soda, Volume 1 by Mayu Murata. This is a high school romance between the two characters here on the cover, and I'm forgetting their names, sorry, but... That's as to be expected from me anyway. The main premise of this story is that this girl here is going into high school, trying to change things around for herself because she was very much bullied in middle school. And so her dream is to just enjoy high school like she was never able to enjoy middle school. So she's trying to just break out of her shell, make friends, and just have a fun time. But, you know, high school starts and it seems like things are going down the same exact way that they did in middle school until one day this dude here, who has hair so yellow it reminds her of the lemon soda that he drinks, so that's the premise for the title. He basically steps in and just tells her to speak up, stand up for herself, and, you know, the story just takes off from there. Honestly, I have mixed feelings about this. Granted, only volume 1 is out. I believe volume 2 comes out in May. I liked it, but I didn't like it, you know? And there were points where I thought the artwork was super cute and I was really enjoying it, and then parts where I didn't like the artwork, mostly in reference to how this character is designed. There's like one jacket he wears in this that just like irritated me, and although that is a very petty reason to not like a manga, I mean, it bugged me. It did bug me. His character really just... I have mixed feelings on. I feel like all of my thoughts on this could just be summed up as mixed feelings, you know? Because I even don't know how I feel about the main hero. I don't know if I like him or not because he's so blunt and so harsh. But at the same time, he's nice at points. And I just don't know how I feel about him. I don't know. I really don't know. Since this is volume 1, I don't really see it as spoiling much. But there is a part after he stands up for her that she is like... fallen in love with him already, and I just, come on now, you're really gonna fall in love with someone just because they stood up for you once or twice? Please, like, there were some pages and panels where I genuinely was very confused. There were a ton of moments that I had to reread multiple times just to like understand what was happening in the scene because it was very clunky, but like I still kind of enjoyed it. I don't know how I feel about this at all. You know what? Maybe I will just have to give volume 2 a chance when it comes out to see my final thoughts and feelings on it, but yeah. I don't know. If anyone here has like read on, just let me know if you think it would be worthwhile for me to continue. All right, so next up we have volumes 1 and 2 of Love of Kill. I thoroughly enjoyed these. I had a great time reading these and I'm 1000% continuing on. But the main premise of this is we have two assassins who don't work together, and then all of a sudden this dude here starts helping her with her targets and who she's assigned to, and we don't really know why. He is just overly infatuated with her and it's so cute. Of course, there's a lot of death and stuff because of the premise and violence as well, but it's so cute. I just had a great time. I really did. It is super fast paced. The art is super cool and very easy to understand. I adore the male lead and I can't wait to learn more about the female lead as we get more background information and more insights into characters' motivations and such things like that. So I'm just excited to continue on with this and just see where the story goes. All right, so I also was able to finish up volume 1 of Queen's Quality, which is the first volume in the sequel series to QQ Sweeper, and I loved it. Again, I just had a great time with it. I love the two main characters. I'm excited to learn more about the side characters if it gets into that. I'm excited to see more of a plot. I'm just excited. I'm excited. I'm loving it. I want to see where the story goes, but volume 2 is nowhere to be found. I'm thinking maybe I just need to wait for it to come back out or come back in stock, I mean, or I could read it digitally, but that means I need to decide if I officially want to collect them physically or digitally, because I think there are, if I'm remembering correctly, about 19 volumes of this out right now, so I don't want to commit if I'm not going to be able to get all of them physically. I do still, however, want to continue the story, so again, just digital physical. Digital, physical. I don't know. Gotta figure that out. All right, so I was also able to finish volume 9 of Spy Family. Had a great time, left with a smile on my face, and I will be continuing the series for sure. This is one I'm not sure if I want to continue. I just kind of have mixed feelings about it, and that is volume 1 of Princess Jellyfish. I didn't love it. I didn't hate it. I'm just completely unsure whether or not it is worthwhile for me to continue collecting this. Our main character here is described as an otaku, and her and a bunch of other otaku women live together in one house. And we see the introduction of this character who helps the main character with a jellyfish situation. This character is actually a man who just loves dressing up as a woman. You get into this character's family and their family drama because they're connected to politics. So it's just like a lot going on. And this is a bind up of the first 2 volumes. We have these beautiful colored pages that starts off volume 1, and then halfway through it, we get more colored pages for volume 2. And I loved that. I love seeing some pops of color, and I thought the artwork was actually pretty cute, so I appreciate that. But like, I only enjoyed 3 characters, this one, and then this one's brother. Can't remember anyone's names. So sorry about that. That's really bad, I know. Those were the only 3 characters I liked. Everyone else was just sort of very rude. Like, everyone was just kind of rude, and I just didn't enjoy that. Also, there was a very weird assault scene, basically, towards the end of this, and it was so out of left field. I just wasn't expecting it at all, and like, it caught me completely off guard, and they didn't really talk about it. It was kind of brushed off, but I don't know if they talk about it more in later volumes. I don't know how it's going to be handled, so taken aback because I didn't expect that at all. Also, there were a ton of cultural references in this that of course went over my head. Not to fault the manga for that at all, because, you know, obviously I'm not going to get a ton of Japanese cultural references, but I will say I don't love a lot of cultural references in my books or manga in general because I feel like it dates them. But who am I to say whether these references dated the story or not, because I just didn't understand most of them, so take that with a grain of salt, you know? And I just don't know if I understood what was going on in this. Not plot-wise, not story-wise, not character-wise, but messaging-wise. Like, what were the messages here? What was the point of this? I'm not sure. And it's only 1 volume, or it's only 2 volumes combined in this 1 volume. So, you know, it's right at the beginning of the story. I don't know how to feel about it. Like, I didn't hate it. Didn't love it. Loved some characters, hated a lot of characters. You know, same kind of thing as Honey Lemon Soda. Just, I don't know how to feel. So if you have read it, let me know your thoughts. Let me know if it's worthwhile to continue it. These editions are $20, which makes sense because it is 2 volumes. So about $10 per volume, but that's kind of expensive just for me to say, like, I don't know if I want to continue this. Okay, so that was about 6 volumes of manga that I was able to get to. I've also been trying to get really into anime, more so than I have been in the past, and I have started a few, keyword on started. So last year I read the first, I believe it was 3 volumes of Hori Mia, and I didn't love them, didn't hate them. That's, I guess, the story of this update. I didn't love it, didn't hate it, you know? I decided to drop the manga, and someone commented telling me that I should give the anime a try. And I said, you know, I'm willing to do that. I'm willing to see if I like the anime more. So I started it, and I got about 8 episodes in, and I just dropped it again because I just got bored. And I wish I was in love with this story so much because so many people love it, but it's just like not that interesting for me. I don't really care about any of the characters. I don't really care about the story. I just wish I loved it so much more than I do, unfortunately, so I had to drop it. I also started Yuri on Ice, and I love the animation so much, but I dropped it after 1 or 2 episodes just because, again, I just didn't care about the story. I was just bored. Oh, it's so unfortunate. And this next one, I'm probably going to mispronounce, but it's like Miyuruko-chan or Miyuruko-chan. Wow, I really cannot pronounce anything. But anyway, that one, I'll have a picture up. And I started it because it seemed like a great premise, and I think I had a friend who watched it and she enjoyed it, so I thought I would give it a go. And, you know, just too much fan service for me. Just an insane amount of fan service, like really bad. I can handle a little bit of it, but if it's like every other shot, no, that's too much for me. Just not my jam. I get it. A lot of people love that. Don't want to step on anyone's toes, but like, I don't like it. I don't want to harp on it too much because I feel like every other video, I'm like, yo, the fan service in this was just too much. I don't like it. So I'm sorry I keep harping on it. I will, you know, just realize it's not for me and move on. So I've been watching Fruits Basket for a very long time now. It's been, if not a year, close to a year. I'm finally on season 3 and I think I'm on episode 8 or 9 and I'm just struggling to finish it. It just got, I don't know, boring. I just guess everything's boring. But anyway, so I actually read up to volume 5 of the collector's editions for the manga, but yeah, I dropped it because I got bored and I was like, I'll just watch the anime because the anime is more entertaining to me. And now the anime is getting boring too. And I'm like right at the end. So I don't know why that is. It's so weird to me. It just kind of got like very repetitive and over the top a little bit. But you know, what else can you expect? I don't know. I'm definitely gonna finish it. Just like, when am I gonna finish it? I don't know. I also restarted Jujutsu Kaisen, even though I just watched it in March. No comment. No comment. Yeah, so that is pretty much my update for now. And Edgar and I are probably gonna go shopping just because I need to pick some more stuff up, you know, continue some series. And I will definitely do a little manga haul when we get back. Thank God for daylight savings and thank God that the days are longer now because I still have enough lighting to film this book haul. We just got back from shopping and I don't recommend the public. I hate going out in public so much, but anyway, I picked up a lot. I have a serious problem, okay? And my problem is spending money on books and manga and such related items. It's a good problem to have, I think. Yeah, so any whoosies, is this crooked? I don't know. Nobody's here for quality anyway, but let me show y'all the haul. This is the haul. Yeah. Let's talk about it. All right, so first up, I picked up volume 1 of The King's Beast, and this is by Rei Toma, who created Dawn of the Arcana. I believe it's set in the same world, but following different characters. I'm assuming it's gonna be romance, you know, because that's just what she writes. But I'm so excited. I don't know anything really about the plot or the premise of it, other than what I just shared. So I'm excited because Dawn of the Arcana was the first manga I ever read and it would just feel so full circle to read this, you know? And then of course I had to pick up Love of Kill. I picked up volumes 3, 4, and 5 and I'm just now noticing the cover of volume 4. That is a choice. No questions asked. I need to get my hands on every single volume and I will not rest until I've read it all. Very much enjoying just very much enjoying. This is probably gonna be read tonight. I completely forgot to say that The King's Beast I actually picked up a few days ago and not today, but I didn't haul it yet, so there we go. I'm hauling it now. Okay, and then I picked up another romance, and that is volumes 1 and 2 of My Happy Marriage. Look at this beautiful artwork. I'm obsessed. I'm in love. I really hope I love the story as much as I love these covers and the artwork that I've seen just by flipping through. I believe that these two main characters are put into an arranged marriage and she kind of has a more dark past. She's working through a lot of things in her mind or emotionally, mentally, what have you. And he is maybe very stoic, a bit closed off and guarded. And then I think he just comes out of his shell to help her just work through her things that she's working through and they fall in love from there. That's what I'm gathering from what I've heard and what I can remember from reading off of the back. I'm having such a great time just embracing this like urge to read manga. I think that it just goes to show if you're in a certain mood, you just have to go with that mood. You just have to read whatever you're in the mood for as a mood reader. That makes sense. I also picked up volume 1 of Kimi ni Todoke and or From Me to You. This is another romance. I genuinely don't know anything about the plot or premise other than I think it was pretty big back in the 2000s and I guess it just got a reprint. The covers drew me in. And I know a lot of people love it. I kind of want to be one of them too. And just look at these two characters. They look so adorable. And I think I'm going to have a great time with it. Well, I hope I'm going to have a good time with it. You know, I don't go into these thinking I'm going to have a bad time. You know, that would be dumb. And then even look at the back. I just love these fun pops of color and the spine. Cute. Yeah, so this says, you know, published in 2005. So definitely the 2000s vibe, which I love. And I'm just in such a romance manga, specifically romance manga mood. And I think it's because it's getting to be springtime and I don't know, it's just like everything's coming back to life and why not be happy and in love, you know? Okay, so the next one I picked up is a romance as well, and I was actually recently recommended it, and that is Say I Love You Volume 1. This is, of course, another romance because I just said that, and I believe it came out in the 2000s as well, if I'm remembering correctly, because I did actually look up the synopsis for this. She had some type of hurt or betrayal in the past and has become very closed off because of it, and maybe even, you know, aggressive because she doesn't want to get hurt again. But everything changes when she meets Yamato, a playboy who's intrigued by this mysterious, violent recluse. I wish I had a bit more to say, so I apologize that this is like, hey, I got this, it's cute. Next, you know, so I'm sorry. I will, of course, update you guys on my thoughts and feelings as, you know, per usual. And we're not done. I still have a few more to haul. So I was also recommended Shortcake Cake. So I picked up volumes 1, 2, and 3. And I'm obsessed with the covers for volumes 1 and 2. I just love the pop of color. I think winter just like wrecked me. And now anytime I see color, I'm like, wow. It's not all gray, but anyway, that was a dumb joke. Sorry. The premise behind this is this main character goes to a high school that is about 2 hours away on bus from where she actually lives. So she decides to move into a boarding house because a lot of kids would have to travel if they didn't have that boarding house. So she moves into the boarding house and, you know, there's 3 girls and 3 guys. Romance and drama probably ensues. I think it's gonna be very cute. It's the same creator, actually creators, because I just recently found out that this is a duo, Sue Morishita. I'm probably mispronouncing that, but I just found out that they're a duo. They are the creators of A Sign of Affection, which is right here. And I didn't really like A Sign of Affection, but I just adore the artwork so much. And I was told that the characters in this are a lot better than the characters in A Sign of Affection and that the artwork is still beautiful. So I was like, yeah, I'm definitely gonna pick this up and get into it and see how I feel. And I'm excited. And I just love the spines. So colorful, so much fun. Look at these little strawberries. That is so cute. But anyway, I had to pick up Call of the Night by Koto Yama. I have volumes 1 and 2 here. They're really glossy. I just know that she's a vampire, he's a human, and that's like literally all I know. But I liked the artwork enough, thought it was intriguing enough to pick up. So here I am picking it up. Lastly, I picked up another romance, and that is In the Clear Moonlit Dusk by Mika Yamori. And I picked up volumes 1 and 2 again. I love the pops of color. Again, you know, just to repeat myself a million times. I know this is from the same creator of Daytime Shooting Star, which I've actually never read. And basically, my understanding of the premise is that this character here looks quite boyish. So a lot of people at her school call her the prince of her school, and they also call him the prince. So they're both like the princes of the school, you know, just like the attractive people, I guess. And it's gonna be like a love story between them. So, very excited. I don't even know how long this vlog is gonna be. It's probably gotta be way too long at this point. I feel like that was a very long-winded haul. So, you know, if you're still here in the video, like thumbs up, thank you so much. Hope that this vlog comes out well. I've never done like a vlog like this, I guess, where it's just manga for an extended period of time. So it's interesting. And I wonder how I'm gonna do this. I don't know. Just kind of spitballing here, just rambling and rambling. I picked up so many great things and I'm having a blast just indulging myself and reading manga. So anyway, I will check back in with you guys when I have another update.
Okay, so this clip is really weird, but let me explain myself. So recently, I have taken to pacing in the middle of the night. Not the middle of the night, but right before I go to bed. I pace around my apartment and I just read a manga while doing it. It's fun, but also I can see it's kind of weird. So anyway, long story short, I read volumes 1 through 3 of Short Cake Cake while doing this, so I don't really have any clips for those, except for this clip here.
Alright y'all, I have spent large portions of both today and yesterday editing this vlog. It's pretty long already. I think we're sitting at almost 30 minutes. I don't know if my laptop can handle much more, so I'm here for the final update. And just to wrap everything up, I read a ton of manga. I watched a ton of anime. I started a new K-drama. Let's just do the last manga update. And I was able to read volumes 1, 2, and 3 of Short Cake Cake. I hate saying that title because it trips me up every time. I really enjoyed these. Very cute, very fun, definitely full of high school drama and just like teenage drama, you know? Yeah, it's pretty much exactly what I said it was gonna be, with the main character moving into a boarding house that's full of other students as well, and you know, romance and drama ensues. There's a love triangle in this which doesn't bother me. I'm actually really enjoying how this love triangle is handled. It's kind of refreshing in a sense, because the two male leads don't hate each other, they're actually friends, so it's just interesting and it creates a really fun dynamic to read about. I guess my like one issue is I just don't understand why they both like her so much, but like, come on, it's high school, it's drama, it's just fun and entertaining. The artwork is great. I am definitely going to continue on with this, and in fact, I've already bought volumes 4 and 5 to continue on with this because I just really want to. It's kind of addicting, like in a weird way. Like I really just want to devour it. I love the little desserts that they have on the backs. They're so cute. It's so cute and fun. I do wish that they had continued with a colored background like volumes 1 and 2, because the white, it's nice, yeah, but come on, the color was so much fun. I was also recommended a K-drama called Rain or Shine, and I'm on episode 4 or 5 now, loving it. It is definitely my new go-to after finishing Tomorrow, The Glory, and then starting Juvenile Justice, but just not getting into it. So I'm so glad that I started Rain or Shine and that it was recommended to me, because I'm thoroughly enjoying it. And like, I want to take my time with it because I don't want it to be over, but I also have to know what happens. So I'm watching it every day, every day. It's just a really interesting premise. So basically the show follows 3 main characters, and all 3 of them were in and or affected by a mall collapse. The mall collapse is set in 2005, and then the show starts off in 2017. So it's been a long time since it happened, and you just really get to sit with these characters and see how that event changed their lives and still impacts them daily. You know, like you see how it changes family dynamics, you see how it changes their mental health, just living with that trauma from that event. And it's just really interesting. It's super good. I'm thoroughly enjoying it, and I actually can't wait to go watch some more later tonight. Yes. Did I have anything else to say? I don't know if I had anything else to add or anything else to say.
It's me editing, and I completely forgot to talk about volumes 3 through 6 of Love of Kill. I absolutely love it. I'm having such a great time with it. I can't wait to read more. Sorry this quality is trash, but yeah, that's what I was forgetting to say. And also in the K-drama Rain or Shine, one of the main characters looks so similar to Gabe from The Office, and I can't unsee it. They just have such a similar body build and shape that it's like so crazy to me just how similar they look. Did it make me dislike his character a little bit? Yeah, but it's not his fault. It's just I hate the character Gabe. So, yeah.
Let me know y'all's thoughts and opinions on vlogs like this that center around mostly just manga and anime and a little bit of K-drama. Just let me know if that's something that's interesting to watch. Because if it is, I can definitely continue with vlogs like this as well. This wasn't too different from my usual anyway, but just let me know. And I hope you have an amazing rest of your day, your night, whatever you're having. Thank you so much for watching. That's pretty much all I have to say.